And yes, and welcome everyone to another modded wacky adventure. This time we're playing Pax Britannica. It's pretty much the Industrial Revolution went on hyperdrive.
Totally normal history.
Yeah, where people end up making automatons and able to convert people into machines.
Tesla ate your heart out. He probably did.
Yeah. And that's why Queen Victoria is still alive.
Yup.
Oh yeah. I can make terror weapons.
Hell yeah. That's how you know you're a good nation.
Yeah, basic chemical compounds. I can make respiratory irritants, pulmonary agents, hallucinogens. Artificial ego death inducement.
What the fuck? I have the sick man of America focus. Great. Good indication.
Holy crap.
Mm.
I just realized there's 20 million people living in London.
Holy shit.
Just in the Greater London area.
That's massive. London sprawl. The world city. Holy shit. Well, for context, I have 25 guys and 13 factories.
Let's go!
Let's go! Carl Dönitz has a piece of Australia.
Carl Dönitz? Oh, yes! Yeah, he's got, Klemzig.
Yeah.
I've been there. It's the first German settlement in Australia. In Adelaide.
Yeah.
I mean, there's French Australia, that's cursed. French Australian Victoria. And the Victoria is New South Wales and Queensland. I'm so amazed that Rudolph the Second is still alive.
Still kicking.
I guess he didn't get super depressed.
Not yet. It will be by the time this game's done.
Alien life?
An anomalous object crash landed outside Governor's M Isle. Okay.
Governor's Mill.
Governor's Mill, I presume, but there's
Grover's
a space
Mill.
There.
Oh yeah.
Grover's Mill. New Jersey this morning. Commonwealth authorities have locked down the surrounding area, although it has nonetheless been swarmed by press and curious onlookers. Scientists on site have stated the object appears to be artificial in construction, resembling a large metal jar. Some have theorized that the object contains extraterrestrials, while others believe it may be a failed British or Russian orbital device. Until the object can be opened and further investigated, however, its origins and intent remain to be seen. What wonders might they bring us?
Yeah, have a look at New Jersey.
Yes.
They have arrived.
Clam Tedog is here.
Extermination or extinction.
God help us all.
I was half expecting them to just land in, like, East Anglia or Norfolk.
Yeah. Yeah, I was expecting them to be in the UK as well.
I sent all my troops over here for one. Okay, I'm at war with them now. Okay, Sussex.
Oh shit.
They have arrived.
Extermination unit Phobos. While the Martian menace rampages across the American Northwest, another pod crashed through the atmosphere and landed in the town of Woking, to the south of the London sprawl. It appears the pod is identical to the one that landed in New Jersey, sparking panic across England as alien invasion now arrives on their shores. The British Expeditionary Force and Home Guard have mobilized to attempt to countermand the invaders. But with many of their troops tied up in North America, their ability to combat the incursion may be greatly reduced. They could have at least invaded Manchester first. Woking is where it happens in the book first, by the way.
Martians are overrun Woking.
No!
133 other countries now declare war on them.
The Great Martian War.
Yep. It's now started.
And before we judge them too harshly, we must remember what ruthless and utter destruction our own species has wrought. Are we such apostles of mercy as to complain the Martians warred in the same spirit? H.G. Wells. Humanity trembles.
And... what did I say?
Aliens land in Tunguska. An intense explosion rocked the Siberian countryside last night as another alien pod crashed into Earth. It has been speculated that the object was originally intended for Western Russia, possibly Moscow or St. Petersburg, but this cannot be ascertained with any certainty. With the remote nature of the region, the Russian army has been slow to respond. Locals have already reported that the Martians have emerged and begun clearing the surrounding countryside, driving refugees in all directions. Many fear that the Martians may successfully take and sever the Trans-Siberian Railway, cutting Siberia off from the rest of Russia. I suppose they went a bit off course.
Well, in the meantime, I'm currently dealing with some election nonsense.
Great.
So yes, democracy still lives during an alien invasion.
So it does.
Naturally, I'm going to get the reactionaries in charge because I think they're the best type of people to deal with aliens.
Yeah, so they are.
Now there's a civil war in Ireland, Vietnam's revolting.
Yeah, I'm dealing with a potential revolution as well. Only three of my states are loyal.
Only three.
The rest are either disloyal or subversive. Oh shit, you beat them.
Yay! Now I'm gonna need to send these guys to Ireland. This is dumb, you know, you got a Martian invasion and yet I'm fighting the Irish.
Yeah.
What's more pressing?
The Irish took the advantage, they were like, yep, it's time.
We will annex Ireland into Great Britain.
Based. So based.
No Irish independence for you.
Not after that hiccup.
No. I'm currently in a space race against Russia as well. Doing a space
we
program.
We need to go to space and kill the Martians there.
Let's go. Has toppled the government of Manchuria. Okay.
Okay. cool, I guess.
Sure.
What about the Martian invasion in your borders, Russia?
I was thinking the same thing. What about those Martians? Oh. Might be able to push them if I throw more Egyptians at them. Hey, that actually did work.
Hell yeah.
Progressive victory in America. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I don't know, sounds gross though.
Maybe you're mad. It's John Curtin.
Hey?
It's John Curtin.
What the fuck? Kill him.
Leader of the Labour Party.
Death penalty.
So I guess in this universe, all the would-be Australians are now in America. We're not gonna give those riskies a chance. Oh, I won.
Nice. United States of China, there you go. By Kai.
United States of China. His name is Kai.
Yeah, I wasn't just making a silly name.
I was just making some silly sound. Like, oh yeah. Some silly Chinese sound, but no, that's literally his name.
Literally his name. I was not fucking with you. Immediately went to war as well, by the way.
Like
3 seconds to be like, alright, war time.
Well, that was spooky, but I managed to deal with the problem.
That's good. It didn't really seem to get out of hand anywhere. Even the Russian one
is
relatively contained still.
Holy crap. From beating the aliens, I got 100,000 infantry equipment and supply now.
Well.
Alright.
I don't have to worry about any wars in the future, are you?
Nah, not a supply issue.
I clicked on Bristol. State's majority culture is Martian.
Be honest, the Martians are no different from anyone else.
You just press gang them into the army, you're like, alright.
You'll be serving in the Royal Navy now. I don't care how many tentacles you have. You'll be sweeping those floors.
The British Empire needs men like you. Okay.
For queen and country.
Whoa, why is it on Dead North as well? What the fuck? Am I at war with all these guys?
Yeah, it looks like you're at war with all of them.
Fuck. Why has it done that? It said it was only gonna declare war on the other ones. Now I'm at war with everybody.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know why. The Imperial Civil War. Well, I guess my troops didn't last too long in your war.
Nope, that's alright though. Opened up some possibilities at least. The reconquest of my rightful clay is going pretty well, I'm gonna be honest with you. As you can probably tell if you look at the map of Mexico.
Ah, yeah. Mexico is looking much better now.
A Mexico sweep.
The Empire United. There'd be a god if he would be like me. To do is paint as much of the map of Earth as British red as possible. Was Rhodes the original map guy?
I just realized I never did the
yeah.
Focus that weakens all the nations I invaded.
So you pretty much just did it on hard mode.
I raw dogged that shit.
What happened? Game's currently frozen for me.
I think the game has crashed.
Oh, no, it's here. League of Earth formed.
Oh my god. Oh. Anti-Martian, I see.
Oh, okay. So Germany becomes the world leader because of aliens. Interesting.
I see, I see. I was going to try and take the rest of, like, all the tribal states and stuff when I got the chance, but...
Yeah.
Anyway. I suppose that's kind of the game, really, isn't it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. As they're just fiddling with rocket stuff.
Yeah. That's it.
I didn't even have a chance to, invoke the National Security Act and bring in the black shirts. Well then, thank you for everyone tuning into this game. It was certainly quite something.
Yeah, it was fun.
And, yeah, I actually did quite enjoy it. Despite all the wacky stuff that was going on. Doing the space race, fighting colonial wars, fighting against aliens. Well then, good luck, and I'll see you all again in the future.
See ya.